You know, Labor Day doesn't resemble any of the films that I've previously made, but I think its DNA is something that's close to my heart, which is, you know, unconventional heroes, people who make decisions for reasons that always don't make sense on paper. And I loved how those two fell in love.
And you said there were times that even you couldn't piece together why the two characters did what they did. So how do you approach situations like that as a director to lead the team?
Well, you know, if I went back through all the decisions I've made in my life, I probably couldn't explain half of them. So I just usually go with my gut. I think that's what a director does. You know, I've worked with Rolf Kent 4 times now, and he took a very different approach on this film. Instead of sending me melodies, he would send me sounds. In each sound, he would label a different form of heat. So one sound would be boiling, one sound would be simmering. And we would start applying the sounds to the different scenes. And it was only late in the game that we started to really apply melody. Right from the first cue in the film, you know, it's this haunting swelling of sounds that plays over the trees, and you realize you're not in for a normal love story.
And what was it about this book in particular that you thought, actually, it needs to be a film?
I don't really have a great explanation for that, except to say that when I read a book that I know I want to adapt, it starts to come together as a movie in my head as I'm reading it. I know what scenes I'm going to keep, what scenes I'm going to delete. I start moving things around. And by the time I read the last page, I feel like I know the movie already, and that's how I know I need to make it. You know, what I needed was just somehow a masterful young actor, and I found him in Gatlin Griffith, this 12-year-old with exceptional eyes, whose eyes the film is really seen through. I saw him at his audition. I was immediately taken by him, and he reminded me of kind of the young lead of like a great, you know, Spielberg 1980s movie.
And at the heart of the story for you, is it about people and human beings needing to connect?
You know, Labor Day at the end of the day is about inexplicable love. It's about the love that doesn't make sense on paper but makes sense in our hearts.